Blast injuries are caused by several explosions. Explosives are categorized as high-order explosives or low-order explosives. High-order explosives like dynamite are designed to use in military, mostly in the battlefield. Explosives like gunpowder and Molotov cocktails and pipe bombs are low-order explosives. Explosives create a very high supersonic pressure wave that expands rapidly and compresses the surrounding air, which spreads as a blast wind in all directions. Then the blast wind interacts with people and objects around the explosive site, causing injuries. There are four categories of blast injuries: primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. Primary blast injury occurs mostly due to high-order explosives, most commonly affecting the people who are staying immediately close to the explosive site or epicenter. A very high pressure wave created by explosion hit the body and compressing the internal organs. The organs are compressed by pressure wave and they rapidly re-expand, causing a shearing force tearing the organs. It is a known fact that air is more compressible than water. Hence, gas-filled organs like ears, lungs, and gastrointestinal tract are susceptible to primary blast injury. This mechanism is also known as barotrauma. If the pressure is mild, it can cause bleeding of the middle ear cavity, which is known as hemotympanum. If the pressure is moderate, it may lead to tympanic membrane rupture. Severe pressure may give rise to a dislocation or fractures of the ossicles in the middle ear cavity. The impact of blast wave results in tearing, hemorrhage, and edema of the lung tissue. Rupture of the alveoli results in pneumothorax or Ehlig syndrome. Rupture of the alveolar capillaries and damage to the endothelium activates the hemostatic mechanism. Deposition of platelet and fibrin onto the damaged endothelium causes consumption coagulopathy or DIC. Blood is extravasated from alveolar vessels into surrounding tissues, compress the alveoli, causing respiratory symptoms like hemoptysis, chest pain, dyspnea, and wheeze. These pathologies result in hypoxia, cyanosis, and potential for respiratory failure. Formation of platelet and fibrin plaque leads to impedance of blood flow, causing ischemia. Impact of blast wave on gas-filled gastrointestinal tract results in intestinal perforation and leakage of intestinal contents into the peritoneum, causing peritonitis, septicemia, and septic shock. Pressure-related injuries to the ear are known as acoustic barotrauma. Injuries to the lungs are known as pulmonary barotrauma, and injuries to the GI tract are known as intestinal barotrauma. Secondary blast injuries occur when flying objects like nails, wood, bricks, and glasses released from the explosion site hit the person and causing injuries. Secondary blast injuries are known as fragmentation injuries. The victim may suffer from multiple blunt injuries or penetrating injuries depending upon the type of fragment hitting the person. Solid organs rather than air-filled organs are more likely to be affected, such as brain, heart, liver, and kidneys. A direct blow to the head by flying objects can cause traumatic brain injuries like cerebral concussion, contusion, lacerations, and even cerebral hemorrhage. Blunt chest injuries may cause lung contusion, causing extravasation of blood into the interstitial tissues, compressing the alveoli, leading to respiratory depression, respiratory distress syndrome, and finally, respiratory failure. Blunt injury to the heart causes hemopericardium, which compresses the heart, causing reduction in ejection fraction, credit output, blood pressure, and finally leads to cardiogenic shock. Blunt injury to the abdomen causes multiple intra-abdominal organ injuries. Collection of blood in the peritoneum causes a rise in the intra-abdominal pressure. If the pressure rises further than 20 mm mercury, it is high enough to compress the inferior vena cava. Therefore, venous return to the heart is reduced, leading to reduced cardiac output and organ perfusion. The organ dysfunctions caused by intra-abdominal hypertension is known as abdominal compartment syndrome. Tertiary blast injuries occur when a person is thrown by a blast wind and hit the nearby objects, causing the structures to collapse upon the person. Types of injuries under this category may be either blunt or penetrating injuries, as well as crash injuries. Commonest type of injuries are fractures like skull fracture, limb fracture, and fracture ribs, especially flay test. Flay test is a traumatic condition of the thorax in which two or more adjacent ribs are broken in at least two places. Collapse of objects onto the body causes crushing of the skeletal muscles known as rhabdomyolysis, resulting in breakdown and leakage of muscle contents into the surroundings. Release of potassium into bloodstream causes hyperkalemia, which may lead to arrhythmia and cardiac arrest. Free myoglobin released from muscles are filtered by kidneys, which is known as myoglobinuria. Myoglobin can precipitate in renal tubules, leading to renal tubular damage and renal failure. All explosion-related injuries not due to primary, secondary, and tertiary blast injuries are considered as quaternary blast injuries. If explosions occur in confined places like a building or a vehicle, there is rapid running out of oxygen, causing carbon monoxide poisoning and inhalational injuries. Bombs exploded with incredible heat may cause severe burn to the victim. Some explosives are attached with radioactive materials so that exposure to such high levels of radiation can cause health effects like cancer in the long run. Next video is about the management of blast injuries. So see you guys in the next video. Study hard and take care.